I wrote a blog post a while ago about why I f***ing hate video games. Because this is what it does. It appeals to, like, the male fantasy.
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the channel. You hear a lot about Hollywood just lacking in ideas, not doing something new. Well, if you're one of those people, if you had doubt that the film industry was moving in the wrong direction, rest assured, BuzzFeed has you covered. That's right, you heard me correctly. BuzzFeed is coming out with a movie. Now, if hearing that confuses you, as it did me, because I was thinking, wait a minute, wasn't BuzzFeed shutting down? I mean, they did close their UK and Australian was a very rednecky way to say that. Australian. I'm never gonna do that again. I apologize. Australian and UK news operations. BuzzFeed is still, in fact, hanging around. I mean, by a thread, or perhaps they even died, and somebody got their hands on the Necronomicon and they brought him back to life as this disheveled, reanimated corpse. Regardless, though, they are bringing us a film that is going to revolutionize the industry. It's going to tell an untold story from a female perspective. Of course, that's the most important thing, but what is this movie, you ask? Well, it's going to tackle the biggest scandal in gaming that's still going on to this very day. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it is going to be a film about Gamergate.
Violent depictions of women being beaten, raped, and run over by cars. It's not the movies, it's video games.
Why are you gay?
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Gamergate is fresh in the minds, the PTSD-addled brains of the people over at BuzzFeed, and honestly, most major gaming news publications these days. I'm actually kind of surprised that Kotaku or Polygon haven't assisted in this virtue-signaling nightmare that this film is sure to turn out to be. You know what I love most about all of this? Gamergate is something that has been said and done for years. It's been over. But the people that keep perpetuating Gamergate are these self-victimized lunatics that keep bringing it up anytime anybody says something they don't agree with, or when somebody disagrees with them, they just immediately start shouting, "Gamergate! It's Gamergate! I'm being oppressed! Please help!" It's fucking pathetic. You have your Brianna Wus, your Anita Sarkeesians, your Zoe Quinns, these scandal-mongering, attention-starved human beings. It is their last cling to relevance, which is why people keep propping it up. These companies like BuzzFeed or like Polygon, they prop up these people because money, but also their own social political agendas. And this right here, this is just the next step of the grift. This movie, I don't see making any money. I don't even know how it's going to be released. Straight to video or straight to streaming? I mean, that's kind of the new hallmark, the quality of garbage. That's the stamp of dog shit, is straight to streaming. It has to be straight to streaming. There's no way this movie is going into theaters. BuzzFeed does not have the money to put a film in theaters. They don't even have money to pay their own staff, so straight to streaming it is. We're going to be taking a look at two different articles today, one a little bit longer than the other. The first one is a CBR article, and that's titled, "Ellen Page Starring in Gamergate-Centric Video Game Comedy, One Up." And boy, if that title just doesn't shout gamer, I don't know what does. It's just, that's something that your parents would say, or, you know, they think, "Super Mario, ha ha ha, it's game, I like game. Do you play, Donkey Kong? I like that game too." Just a really boomer-ass title from people that are not involved in the industry, at least in any significant fashion. These people are the ones that are playing mobile games on their phones, and they say, "I'm a gamer too, therefore you need to listen to me." And trust me, we're going to be talking about some statistics here pretty soon, so brace yourself. Anyway, shitty title aside, let's go ahead and read about what this movie's about, at least according to CBR, because, the second article that we're going to be taking a look at from Hollywood Reporter, the synopsis of the film is a little more interesting, more backhanded, I guess I would say. We'll get to that shortly. So according to the CBR article, 1UP is going to be about a pro gamer named Vivian Lee who quits her college team due to repeated incidents of sexism. She recruits a varsity caliber team. A varsity caliber team, keep that in mind, made up of all female members in order to hold on to her scholarship. And I can already see where this is going. Obviously, you're going to have a group of men who say you just suck at video games because you have a vagina, blah, blah, blah. Something we've all heard before. It's not going to be anything new or creative because let's face it, these people are not the creative types. They're going to be targeting this film to the lowest common denominator. So you can't make it that confusing. You can't have subtlety. That doesn't exist. And I just have to point out a real-world situation in which somebody tried to make an all-female esports competitive team and it didn't really work that well. And that's putting it lightly. When I say it didn't really work all that well, I mean it was an absolute failure. Take a look at this team, a Russian all-female League of Legends team loses 52-2 in the LCL, which is the League of Legends Continental League. I mean, that is just absolutely awful. This team was dropped because they could not compete at the same level as everybody else, and it has nothing to do with the fact that they're women. It's just unfortunately the team they put together was used as some kind of publicity stunt, and it backfired completely because now it makes it look like women can't play the game, which I assure you is not the case, and I don't think anybody would make that argument. It's just what happens when you try to virtue signal in a space that is very much a meritocracy. Gaming in general is a meritocracy. The better you are, the higher the level you can compete at. That's what's great about games. I've said it time and time again. It doesn't matter what gender you are or what you identify as, it is an equalizer. Your skill is all that matters when it comes to competing in games. It's also what makes it so unifying. It's what makes it such a unifying hobby for everybody because it doesn't matter what your politics are, it doesn't matter what your gender is, or what God you believe in, or what you don't believe in, it doesn't matter. Everybody's there to play the game, have fun, compete, enjoy the game experience together. And that's what bothers me so much about people that keep bringing up this Gamergate garbage, that it's an online harassment campaign and gamers hate women, they're all sexist, racist, istophobes. It's just a constant barrage of disparagement towards gamers, and it's fucking disgusting. But let's pivot back to the movie really quick. Let's look at the Hollywood Reporter article that I mentioned a little bit earlier. The way that this article describes the film, I said it was backhanded. It's really odd how they decided to frame this. I don't know if they're trying to make it a positive thing or if they're really just saying these people are incompetent. The quote from the article reads, "The story centers on a female gamer named Vivian Lee who quits her college esports team rather than put up with sexism from her male counterparts. But with her scholarship on the line, she's forced to assemble a varsity caliber all-women's team that can compete with the boys, with the help of an enigmatic coach who returns to the spotlight after her own Gamergate scandal. The young woman recruits an unlikely crew of unskilled misfits to kick some serious gamer butt." Oh my god, that sounds awful. But what I want to highlight there is unskilled misfits? Are you trying to compete or are you trying to lose? I don't really understand. Or are you hoping that your gender is what's going to give you a pass in the gaming competition? You're just going to show up and people are going to immediately start simping because you're women. I mean, that might work over on Twitch, but that's not going to work in a competitive esports environment. Let me tell you. Trust me, I know from experience. I tried to do a little, you know, a little nip slip and I just got banned and I got thrown out. So why would you call them unskilled misfits? Isn't the whole point to show that women can compete, that women can actually be better than men playing video games? Why highlight the fact that they're unskilled? Do you see what I mean? This whole movie is based off of an incredibly flawed idea of what Gamergate actually was. It is and always has been and always will be pushback from people that are actually in the culture, actually a part of the hobby, trying to keep social justice politics out of gaming. And as I've said before, that clearly failed. And now we have people like Brianna Wu and Anita Sarkeesian and Neil Druckmann who are constantly poisoning the well of gaming. These are individuals that don't care about the hobby. They just see it as a way to push their own political agendas, and it's sad, but that's where we are. It leads to films and conversations like this, with this complete and disingenuous framing of what Gamergate actually was. And these are mostly the same people that'll say, well, women make up half of all gamers, so why aren't you catering to women? Why is it all about the male power fantasy? This is the same thing that we saw when it came to the Assassin's Creed situation, the AC Sisterhood, where people were very upset that Ubisoft would leave out female assassins from a promotional video that they put out on Twitter, and the argument that I made then is the same one that I'll make now. Most of their customers are men. Most people that are playing the Assassin's Creed games are men. And it's not to say that women don't play those games, because that would be ridiculous. Of course they do, but the statistics don't match up. If you are in fact one of those people who still believe the ridiculous myth that women make up half of all gamers, well, I have a large dick for you to swallow. I mean, large pill for you to swallow. Large pill. If we take a look at some of these numbers by Quantic Foundry, you'll see that a large portion of female gamers are actually playing things like farm simulators or The Sims, casual puzzle games. 69% are playing match 3 games, 69% family farm sim games, 42% casual puzzles. You can see that these games are mostly mobile games or browser-based games. These are not things that you would typically consider gamers to be playing. I mean, I don't consider somebody who plays Candy Crush every now and then to be a gamer. Sorry to all of you moms out there, all the MILFs watching these videos, because I know you're definitely watching this. The numbers just don't add up. That 50-50 split is such a bullshit myth. And if you disagree with my classification on what somebody would be called a quote-unquote gamer, that's totally fine. You don't have to agree with me, but I think that if you actually talk to anybody that is involved in the hobby itself, spending multiple hours a day playing games, I'd have to say I think they would agree with me. Honestly though, I am excited to see what this movie has in store for us, because I really do think it's going to be a glorious dumpster fire of a film. It'll be good for a few laughs, I think, but it has the real possibility of doing a lot of damage to the image of people in the games industry. I mean, when you have large media corporations like BuzzFeed saying that, look at all of these disgusting, terrible men, they don't want women anywhere near games, you're going to have idiots who see that and believe that, and then view anybody in the hobby as some racist, sexist, terrible human being. So while it may be fun to point and laugh at BuzzFeed just desperately trying to regain any sort of relevancy, I do think that it's an issue and something that needs to be addressed, which is why I'm making this video, and I'm very glad to see everybody else who's covering this as well. I'll leave you with some very wise parting words. If you have a vagina and tits, play some fucking video games. If you got a dick and balls, play some video games. Who gives a shit? Just have fun. Fuck this movie. Fuck BuzzFeed. That's what I have for today's video. As always, I want to know what you think about all of this. Are you excited to see 1UP? Are you going to be lining up at the box office or glued to your TV or your monitor, whatever? Are you excited to watch this movie? Let me know down in the comments below. If you like the video, drop a like, and if you really want to support this channel, hit the subscribe button and make sure that you have all notifications turned on so you don't miss a single video. If you really want to make sure that you're getting all of the Metal Gear Mando content that you need, join the Discord. A link is down in the description below for that MGM Mother Base. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter, by the way, at Metal Gear Mando, and now you can also find me over on Twitch, same name, Metal Gear Mando. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, stay safe, and I will see you in the next video.